This isn't the first review you'll read that heaps praise on the Mazda 3. It's been a reviewer favorite for years now, which should be no secret to regular readers. The 2017 model carries things further in a positive direction, though in a very low-key way. For the sake of those just now joining us, I'll run through the model's baseline attributes once more. There's its curb appeal, for one. It's probably the best-looking, cleanest sedan in this class. If you think the new Civic sedan is a tad overwrought, here's an antidote. The 3 hatchback gets slightly more balanced lines to go along with its enhanced functionality, and the larger Mazda 6 sedan makes for a prettier, more elegant 4-door, but for a compact sedan? Not bad. Plus, the very fact that I can even remember that Mazda's design language is called Kodo, Soul of Motion, speaks volumes about how clearly it stands out in a crowded field. Another thing we've emphasized time and time again, it's a good driver. It's not quite a GDI, nor is it trying to be, although I have no doubt Mazda could fight that fight if it wanted to, but it's not a chintzy Econobox either. Does it drive better than the 2016 Mazda 3? Yes, slightly, but the reason why is complicated. Beginning with the 2017 model year, Mazda is rolling out its so-called G-Vectoring control steering system across its model lineup. The software-based system, which, despite its name, has nothing to do with torque vectoring, cuts engine power marginally when you turn the steering wheel. This loads up the front wheels and creates a more stable, predictable, and theoretically less fatiguing directional control experience. The power cut is unnoticeable, and the system itself is very nearly so, which is exactly the point. I tested G-Vectoring control a few months ago at Laguna Seca, Mazda Raceway Laguna Seca, and yes, it works. You'll saw less at the wheel while driving in a straight line or changing lanes, and you'll make fewer corrections while turning. But it's very much operating in the background. If you try to feel it in action, you'll miss it entirely, or even worse, overcorrect. This time around, I drove the Mazda 3 roughly 1,000 miles from Detroit to Hershey, Pennsylvania, and back. On the road, as on the test track, the G-Vectoring control system works as advertised. The ability to set the steering wheel when entering a corner on a mountain turnpike, and just leave it there throughout the turn, is a little eerie. I do wonder if the average driver will notice, which is both a testament to Mazda's efforts to maintain a pure driving experience and a sales challenge. How do you trumpet a system that works almost entirely invisibly to make a good driving car drive marginally better? How can I explain this to friends when they ask for a new car recommendation? I'm at a loss. But that doesn't make the Mazda 3 any less worthy. It's not a bargain bin buy at $27,730, just about the upper limit for the model, but Mazda's premium push helps justify the sticker. It isn't just the nicer materials throughout, it's stuff like the pop-up heads-up display and driving safety features, which you might only come to appreciate on hours-long cross-country slogs. Or, you can leave that all behind and get a more basic 3 and still enjoy its fundamental goodness for closer to its sub-$20,000 starting price. The choice is yours. There's a reason the segment's top sellers are top sellers, but there are plenty of reasons why we consistently recommend the Mazda 3 to those in this corner of the market. And it gets better for 2017, if only subtly. Go check it out. Read more, http://autoeek.com/article/car-reviews/2017-Mazda-3-Grand-Touring-Review-R-Favorite-Hatch-Number-9ZZ4ZRGF15